Hey, long riders, welcome to Tuesday's tying video where we tie flies that catch fish, not only fishermen. And we got a good one too today, my version of the Royal Wulff. And let's get to it. We got a size 12 hook with 70 denier black thread to start this fly. And we'll start winding on the hook shank back to where we go ready to tie in the So for the tail, we're going to use the brown part of a deer tail. I have a yellow dyed deer tail, so it kind of adds like a yellow tint to the brown. I've used red, I used green, I used pink, but use the brown part. And they all look pretty cool. You want the tail to be the same length as the hook shank. Now we're going to tie in peacock, the first strand of peacock. I use a UV peacock. If you don't have UV peacock, use regular peacock. But if you can get your hands on some UV peacock, it works really well. Now we're going to be on the second bobbin, we have a red thread. And we're going to tie that in right next to the peacock, run it up, hook shank, and whip finish that, and cut it off. Or you could just tie it down with the black thread. Now we're going to tie in your second strand of peacock. And then you want a little bit of red in between the peacock. So you're going to go back on that red and tie it, wrap it up. Make sure you leave enough room for wing, hackle, and eye. Some people tie on the wing. You could have done that first if you don't feel comfortable tying them this way. Go tie the wing on first. So that way you don't overcrowd the eye. Now for the wing, we're going to tie right up against that last peacock. It's brown poly yarn. Now you can use black, you can use white. I prefer the brown. And I'm going to put a lot of poly yarn in it because I'm going to use these for dry droppers. So I'm going to put a big wing on it. Now you're going to figure eight this wing and wrap some around the base of the wing. Now to hold them stand up. I don't got far to go yet. This is a killer, deadly dry dropper pattern. A lot of fish hit this thing when Susa hits the water. Alright, now you want to cut that wing the same length as the hook shank. So you can hold a hook up next to it to trim it, or you can eyeball it. But you need to cut it the same length as the hook shank. Okay, now directly behind that wing, we're going to tie in some black hackle. I'm going to wrap it like 3 to 4 times behind the wing, once in front, maybe 2. Don't overcrowd that eye, and you're going to tie that hackle off. Clip that hackle away. Hey, I hope you like that fly. I love this. This is my favorite fly to use as a dry for a dry dropper with a nymph as a dropper. Above me, you can see a nymph that I suggest you use from an earlier video. Keep your lines wet out of the trees and only give them fish a sore lip. See you next week. Have a good day.